As we look at this ongoing mission here, tell us what you see and what folks should keep in mind to make sense of what is a truly unusual and historic NASA event here.
Yeah, I think, first of all, the thing is, you know, this is a triumph of American science, you know, to see the ongoing development of commercial space program, right? Having a commercial space enterprise, which is so important for the future of humanity, right? If we're really going to become a spacefaring civilization, which, you know, if you want to think about the next 300, 500 years of humanity, that's what we're going to do if we make it past climate change.
I'm going to jump in and we're going to see if we can listen in to the actual combined broadcast of the NASA SpaceX mission here. We are using, as I mentioned, their video feed. You can see the NASA logo in the corner. Let's listen in as we think we're getting close to this historic disembarking.
We can see folks on board clapping as our first crew member.
And that is NASA astronaut Nick Hague, commander of Crew 9, now out of Crew Dragon Freedom. Some smiles, thumbs up, and a wave. Can't get any better than that.
Yeah, that is one happy camper, that's for sure. As we said before, it is standard procedure for all of our long-duration crew members to receive assistance upon egressing from the spacecraft. We basically help them move off of the recovery deck and into the private medical quarters for their initial consultation with the SpaceX flight surgeon. So we'll see that take place for all four of our crew members today.
All right, so we've been listening in there, and that is the first astronaut to disembark. That was Nick Hague, as identified there from Crew 9 by this NASA SpaceX feed. Adam, we have the Williams and Wilmore still inside, and I believe, as they just alluded to, we're now going to watch this process safely play out for the other three coming up next. Tell us your thoughts, Adam, as an expert here, as we watch this play out.
Well, first, can I just say, like, how cool is this, right? Those guys were in space, right? You know, I mean, they were, you know, it's phenomenal that human beings who've spent 300,000 years, as long as we've been around, looking up, now have this capacity to send people up there, right? For the entire history of Earth's origin or Earth's existence, stuff has only fallen down, right? Meteors fall down. And now we've reached a point where we can blow stuff back out, including us. So just watching this happen safely and watching those astronauts come out, I think my main emotion is jealousy, right? Like, why not me? I want to go. So I'm very happy to see this. I'm really amazed at the technology and the brilliance of the SpaceX engineers. And of course, I have to note the irony that, you know, all those brilliant SpaceX engineers you know, got their training at American universities, at American science programs. And of course, that's what's under threat right now, you know, by this administration.
Yeah, I'll jump in to say this is Alexander Gorbachev, who was a Russian cosmonaut and is now the second astronaut there. You can see with a happy wave being moved out through that process on the slide stretcher. That means Williams and Wilmore, who have been the subject of so much interest, are coming out next, Adam.
Right. And so that brings us to what we were talking about before, was the idea, you know, this whole idea of them being stranded and how it really just evolved into politics. And that, you know, as they said, they were happy to be there. Of course, they missed their families. But, you know, their families, no, they're astronauts. They're heroes. This is what astronauts do. Things can go wrong. They were never in any danger at all. And they got to look out that window. You know, there's that amazing, they call it the cupola, that window that looks down on Earth. And, you know, the astronauts end up gathering there at the space station because it's almost a spiritual experience to look down on the planet where there are no borders, right? There's no lines drawn on the planet that separate Ukraine from Russia, from Poland, from And I think, you know, every astronaut, they call it the overview effect. You know, to have months to be able to, you know, let that seep in, I'm sure that they were, you know, this is probably, they're going to look back on this as being the most profound experience of their lives.
Yeah, and Adam, you know, for folks joining us here, we've been following the live NASA SpaceX feed as we await the egress, the disembarking of Williams and Wilmore, these two astronauts who've been up there for a long time. And your enthusiasm and your sort of scientific passion is coming through because you're reminding everyone the power of this technology and the interest. I'm going to bring in Wayne Hale, a retired NASA flight director and space shuttle manager. Wayne, welcome to this moment.
Good evening. It's good to be here.
It's great to have you. I think we're going to listen in again to this SpaceX NASA broadcast for these disembarkings, and then we'll hear from both of our guests here in a moment. Let's listen in and experience this together.
You know, just 5 years ago, when we were doing the initial demonstration missions of the Dragon for Crew Dragon, that now we're under about 30 minutes for to retrieve the spacecraft from the water, and just several minutes here while it's been on board, and to get everyone, really, to get that side hatch open. For those of you that have just recently joined, the Dragon had an on-time splashdown. Oh, it looks like we're getting our next crew member here. That is none other than Sunny Williams. Big smile, big waves. She, like her other crew members, now will be assisted onto the mobility aid.
And there we have it, some waves, some thumbs up, and some smiles.
Definitely seems to be a theme among all recovery operations.
Absolutely. And of course, that leaves NASA astronaut Butch Wilmore inside Dragon in seat 4. We're getting some views of him now as he egresses or exits the spacecraft.